Hey all, Norman here. Well, I'm going to be talking about the EPZ Sony E-mount 18 to 105 f4 lens. It's been around a long time. It was first introduced back in 2013, where you see, and I've sort of read comments from 2016 on up, you either love or you hate this lens. That's basically how the reviews have been, but more love on this particular lens, love-hate relationship. But you have to understand this lens and the purpose of it. So let me give you a little bit of description of this. This is a good lens to upgrade to that I will get to at the end of this video. But what this basically is an, like I said before, an 18 to 105 f4 lens. Everything's internal electronic inside. It has steady shot with the handy cam capability of technology. So this has like a nice little video. If you did video, this would have that nice little feature that I've hardly ever used. Everything electronic, so it's a little delayed when you zoom in, such things as that. So it's a lens you have to get used to overall. It has a 72 filter mount on the top, metal base for mounting onto the camera. Like I said, this is considered a G-class lens that I sort of question, but that's just me. So let's go ahead and check out the videos and footage that I did today over at the Renaissance Festival here in the Carolinas. But I decided just to use this lens with my Sony A6400 today that I'm currently recording on right now. So I'll be right back in a few minutes. Tell you my opinion of this lens, and is this something that I could really recommend from an upgrade from the kit to this lens. Be back. Enjoyed those pictures from the Carolina Renaissance Festival. Like I said, I just used this lens overall for the day. This lens is a good all-around lens. So let me tell you about the pros and cons of this lens. It is something that I would consider upgrading from your kit lenses. That, what is it? I think it's the 16 to 50, and then there's the 55 to 210. Now I consider this maybe the better lens for that. It doesn't have the reach like the 55 to 210 lens, but with the steady 4 f/4 stop, that makes a difference on here with maybe a little bit of, there's a tad low light when you need it. Now, as for focusing, this has always been a love-hate relationship. Like I said, this has come out since 2013. Technology's changed on it. Even with the A6400 focus system on here, this struggles sometimes overall. From when I zoom in, I do realize I see it's not that perfect tack sharpness, like if I would be using my, of course not with my prime lenses, or using, of course, with any of the G Master lenses. And that's where I bring back, I question with why they even really ever considered this as a G Master lens quality. It is built very nice overall. There is a downside with flash if you're using the A6000 series. It brings a shadow to the flash. So if I take a picture of somebody, you're gonna get, okay, you'll get this part flash, but then the rest of me will be, the rest of my face is dark. The downside of that lens with using that flash. So you almost have to have another flash because there is a hot shoe mount on the A6000 series, and you're gonna have to use, I would say, almost bounce off the walls for lighting to get that even light when you do use this particular lens. So that's another downside of this lens. It does, when I was doing standard taking pictures of people, as you saw there up close, this actually did really well overall when I had the time to focus in on that person and capture that moment. Now, the thing is I had to focus. This did struggle where sometimes it'd be back focusing, and that was sort of a little bit of a pain. So I ended up had to change it to center focus a couple times to get right onto the person that I wanted to take a picture of. It could be a firmware update. I might be checking to see if they actually have one on this. I haven't done one yet in a while with this lens, and I did buy this lens used at the start of this year. So this lens, as for action, do not recommend it. We were taking pictures of Falcons as they're flying. I had one that flew right at me, was not ready for it. If I had like the Sony A70 to 200, it would have been able to be spot on and capture it as it flew towards me, because I have tested something like that with the A6400. This one struggled. I was lucky to get maybe two shots before I lost the shot of the Falcon as it flew towards me. So that's one of the downsides of this lens, of being the generation being a little bit older overall. So I think that's about really the only downside. If you're using it for your general overall travel shoot, if you just need one lens that you need to be able to do those general shots, this is definitely one to consider as an option overall for an f4 lens. I'm hoping they will have an upgraded version of this particular model soon to a version 2, and I might actually consider that as the lens, because actually the range is perfect. So anyways, thanks for watching. We'll catch you later. Bye. And the game is hard to lay down. I'm kidding.